Hello, Cloud Gurus. July 2021 has been a great month for GCP. We've had a new region come online in Delhi, India. The next big thing, registration is now open for Google Cloud Next 21 online, and Google helps you not shoot yourself in the foot. I'm your host, Mattias Andersson, and you're watching GCP This Month with all this and more. All right, big news. Google is now online with their new region in Delhi, National Capital Region, India. This Asia South 2 region is full-featured with three separate zones and support for tons of GCP products and services, including BigQuery, Bigtable, Cloud Run, Cloud SQL, Cloud Spanner, Cloud Storage, Cloud VPN, Compute Engine, Dataflow, Dataproc, GKE, Memory Store, Secret Manager, VPC, and more. Also, for GCP customers who are located in India, not just doing business there, there are two more quick things to note. First, GCP invoices can now be paid by scanning a unified payment interface or UPI QR code. And second, Google has some updated information for you about their tax deducted at source or TDS compliance. I could really go for some vindaloo and palak paneer right now. Next, mark your calendars and sign yourself up in either order, but definitely do both of those things. Google Cloud Next 21 is happening on October 12th to the 14th. The link to get more info and to register is in the video description. I see that Kelsey Hightower and Sarah Robinson have already been listed as two of the featured speakers, so I'm looking forward to catching their talks among others. Now, this will be a completely digital event again this year, so there's no need for you to arrange travel or worry about COVID. You can enjoy everything from the comfort and safety of your own desk. And to be honest, I'm rather relieved that it's a 3-day sprint this year, not another 9-week marathon. But hey, let us know in the comments which one you prefer. 3 days? 9 weeks? I'm curious. Now, normally, I like when Google makes things easier, and they've definitely done that with a number of things this month. But I sometimes also get happy when Google makes some things harder. And that's exactly what they've done with their new Cloud Storage Public Access Prevention in preview. Because harder is a good thing when it's in regard to making a mistake, especially a security mistake like taking private data and making it public. Do a search for public bucket breach and you'll see what I mean. To solve this way too common issue, Google has added the ability to restrict your buckets from the possibility even of becoming public. No one can open up public bucket access when this is turned on. You can set this powerful option anywhere you want in the resource hierarchy, including the folder level. As Google says, you should use public access prevention if you know your data should never be exposed on the public internet. To provide the most security to your resources, we recommend enforcing public access prevention at the highest possible level of your organization. Good security is good business. Okay, now let's move on to our quick bites. Anthos is branching out and it's now possible to create your own Anthos managed stuff on Microsoft Azure. And when I say stuff, I mean Kubernetes clusters, load balancers, storage volumes, all those Anthos-y things. Google's Cloud Certificate Authority CA service is now generally available. Now, this is all about enabling you to set up your own private certificate authority, integrating it with HSMs, hardware security modules, and making it scalable, highly available, and completely serverless with pay-as-you-go pricing. Oh, and by the way, there's also already a Terraform provider for this too. Predictive Autoscaling for Compute Engine managed instance groups is now generally available. And another new improvement to Compute Engine, snapshots of persistent disks can now be application consistent, not just crash consistent. You no longer have to manage flushing the memory to disk yourself. Now let's take a look at a few quick updates on Cloud SQL. First is that the SQL Server flavor now supports SQL Server 2019 and auth through Active Directory, both in general availability. Second is that Cloud SQL now supports cross-region replicas, or CRRs, in all flavors, now that CRRs are also in preview for SQL Server. Also, the MySQL flavor has just gotten support for database authentication through GCP's Identity and Access Management, or IAM. You no longer have to set and manage database-level passwords, which I'm sure some people thought was fun, but not the same ones. Another good thing for security, you can now set Kubernetes Engine Role-Based Access Control, or RBAC, through Google Groups. This is way more maintainable and therefore also more secure than managing access at the account level. If you're using Dataflow or Apache Beam for your data processing pipelines, you should take a look at whether the new Dataflow GPU support would benefit you. Dataflow GPU makes it very easy to take advantage of SIMD parallel processing, that's single instruction multiple data, without having to manage any of the details yourself. Google shows the speed up for an example natural language processing ML pipeline that they use, dropping from 166 minutes to just 10. I wish I could get that kind of speed up for other things in life, right? Google's Ops agent, now generally available, is made to replace their older and separate logging and monitoring agents. This reportedly supports 15 times higher throughput for logs than the legacy logging agent, another dramatic improvement. BigQuery now supports taking a point-in-time snapshot of a table in preview. Snapshots are read-only and relatively low cost because they only store and charge you for the data delta, not the full table. Well, all right, I hope you found this valuable. If you did, please hit that like button. And if you want to keep up to date with cloud, then hit that subscribe button too. And if you just need to get some work done, then hit the close button before YouTube sucks you in. Or, you know, look up more of our videos so you can keep learning. And I hope that you can soon put some of these things to use in your own situation. Oh, by the way, we recently did a webinar panel event thingy. Well, I don't know what to call it, but it's jam-packed with all sorts of insight you can use to help your organization understand how to succeed with cloud, and you personally too. The live event has passed, but you can still check out the recording. It's called Cloud Rules Everything Around Me, and I'll put a link in the video description alongside all the more detailed news articles. Well, that's all for me. Take care, stay safe, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.